The DFL presents two new Bundesliga Match Facts. First, ball recovery time.
It's just marvellous technique.
And keeper efficiency.
Look at that!
If you want to score goals,
drilled into the top. That was a fine strike.
You need the ball. It's tactically interesting to know how quickly a Bundesliga team wins the ball back after losing possession. And to find out, the DFL has introduced the new Bundesliga Match Fact, ball recovery time. This new stat shows precisely how quickly a team regains possession, with different teams opting for different strategies, depending on their strengths and weaknesses. Teams like Bayern currently have a playing style where they look to dominate and be constantly in possession. When they lose the ball, they immediately want it back, so they press early and high. It means their ball recovery time value is quite low.
And now Coman to sprint away. It's Coman for Bayern, away from Renault to make it two!
Here again against Augsburg, Bayern want the ball back quickly after a turnover. They look to counter-press. Bayern are the Bundesliga leaders here. They want to dominate through winning the ball. And when that happens near the opposition goal, there isn't far to go for a shot. Here, the ball is recovered after just 7.5 seconds, thanks to Joshua Kimmich. Bayern then launch a new attack through him, resulting in a goal.
João Cancelo with a great ball in. Alphonso Davies with a terrific goal.
Other teams allow their opponent to control proceedings and only begin attempting to win the ball back in their own half. Lying in wait is Union Berlin style, as seen by their ball recovery time against Leipzig, which is far higher than that of their opponent. Their quick attacks mean this is still a tactic that works very well for them.
And it is Geraldo Becker who cuts inside and finds the top corner.
A turnover of possession can be a key moment. The question each team must then answer is whether to press or allow the opposition to come at you. Like Union, Bayer Leverkusen prefer to maintain their shape and drop back before striking at the right moment. After losing the ball here against Bremen, they don't immediately push, they wait. The forwards drop back and allow Werder to take control of the play. Only once they're back in their shape is the player in possession targeted. So ball recovery time allows insight into the tactics of a team. Pressing or regrouping into formation is a question of playing philosophy. Ball recovery time doesn't automatically say anything about the quality of a team. If you have quick attackers like Leverkusen, sitting and countering can be a very good approach.
The touch makes there! It's 3-1!
This new Bundesliga Match Fact can also show how a team's philosophy changes within a game. When you're trailing, you need to chase more. Like here in Bremen's game against Gladbach. After twice going behind, Werder vastly reduced their ball recovery time in the second half, choosing to attack more quickly in search of an equaliser.
Dirks! How cool was that? From Marvin Dirks!
Ball recovery time also shows how good a team is at avoiding losing possession. Like Borussia Dortmund here against Köln, who are usually very quick to win the ball back, but are given no chance on this occasion. Köln's ball recovery time in this game was far higher than the average for the season. Dortmund just moved the ball around and are then clinical in attack. So ball recovery time can also show when a game plan isn't working.
It's Marlon and now Guerrero!
Ball recovery time, the new Bundesliga Match Fact powered by AWS, provides useful analytical insight into the general philosophy of a team, but also how tactics change within a game, and when a team is forced by an opponent to go from reacting to being proactive. It compares the performances of two teams and demonstrates whether one side is able to implement its game plan or not. They often have a hand in the game. They possess unbelievable reactions. And they decide matches.
Wow, he saved it! And that is a fabulous save! Absolutely spectacular reactions there!
The goalkeepers of the Bundesliga. finally, there's a Bundesliga Match Fact powered by AWS that accurately measures and evaluates their performance. Keeper efficiency. Keeper efficiency is based on the so-called X saves value. This figure reveals the probability of a shot on goal being saved. Like expected goals, X goals, each shot is analyzed individually and compared against historic data. Unlike the calculation of X goals, only attempts that are actually on target are taken into account. This is used to calculate immediately after the finish how likely it was that the ball could be saved. If a goalkeeper saves more shots in a game than he's statistically expected to based on X saves, he has a positive keeper efficiency, the mark of a top performance. To better understand it, let's look at Frederic Reno's performance against Frankfurt. He's one of the reasons why Union Berlin emerged victorious against Eintracht. The Eagles had 20 shots on goal, and according to the goal probability, could have scored almost 3 goals. The fact that didn't happen is down to Reno. Out of all 6 of the efforts that were directly on target, the X saves value say he should have saved 4. But the Danes stopped all 6 and kept his team in the game. So the keeper efficiency shows that he saved 2 more shots than was statistically expected. Union Berlin owe the victory in part to Renault's excellent performance.
Daichi Kamada denied by Frederic Renault.
In the match against Leverkusen, Gregor Kobel was instrumental in ensuring Dortmund's victory. He faced 7 attempts on his goal and parried all 7 with great saves. At the end of the encounter, his keeper efficiency stood at 1.2. In other words, he saved 1.2 shots more than he should have done based on the X-Saves model, making him the top shot stopper on that match day. Rafał Gikiewicz's performance against Bayern München was outstanding and a crucial factor in Augsburg's win. The keeper efficiency of 2.4 demonstrates that Gikiewicz saved nearly 2.5 shots more than was statistically expected from Bayern's attempts on goal. Another top display.
Excellent goalkeeping. Gikiewicz is proving a source of great frustration for Bayern so far.
Of course, there's more to good goalkeeping than the number and quality of shots saved. And keeper efficiency doesn't say who the best keeper is. Shots that go off target because of, for example, good positioning like Reno's here against Wolfsburg aren't factored into the calculation at all. Reno plays a significant role in preventing a goal by cleverly reducing the angle. However, this is not included in the measurement of keeper efficiency, because the ball is not going on target. The new Bundesliga Match Fact keeper efficiency powered by AWS recognizes a goalkeeper's performance and makes it more transparent.